Hey guys, Leanne here on Grady's Mom. I'm starting a new week of what we cooked and ate for dinner. So tonight I've got some marinated. This is the tomato basil marinade from McCormick. We love their marinades. And last night before bed, I put 3 large chicken breasts in the marinade. So it's been marinating almost 24 hours. Nice chicken breasts here. We just got a new grill pan. It's pretty much identical to the last one we had, but the last one we had, I think about 4 to 5 years, it was so rusted and disgusting that I just knew it was time. So I usually put foil on the old one because it had a lot of rust, but it was still really functional, but I didn't want my food touching the rust, obviously. So this one's obviously brand new. My husband took off the handle that came with it because he does not like the handle. It's just preference. So I'm going to go ahead and put some yellow squash and zucchini that I got at a farmer's market directly in here since it's all washed and clean and not rusty. I'm going to put this all in here. I'm going to toss it in some olive oil. I'm going to season with some black pepper and some of this Trader Joe's onion salt, which I love, love, love. This is like one of my favorite seasonings for veggies and potatoes and rice. So we're going to do that tonight with the chicken on the grill, and I'm also going to go ahead and get some rice going, and I'll show you what it looks like as always when everything is done. So this dinner came out really good. I find that doing grilled chicken breasts or chicken thighs or some kind of chicken on the grill once a week in the warmer months is really a lifesaver, and it's just easy. It's good every time, and I definitely recommend it. Alright guys, I'm about to start dinner. I'm actually doing a home chef dinner tonight. This is the baked Italian sausage farfalle, and if you've been watching my channel for a while, you know that I love anything pasta, sausage, or baked, especially like a pasta bake. So I've got all the ingredients laid out here. I'm going to get the farfalle noodles going. I'm going to slice up the zucchini. I'm going to get the sausage out of the casing and fry that up, and I've got everything I need here. It does come with this little ciabatta bread, and it says you need to cut it in half and then you have like half a piece of garlic bread with it. But I think what I'll do instead of that is just make a little salad, like a side salad as well. So I'm just going to go ahead and do this. I love the convenience of these because, as you can see, I have everything here that I possibly need. Right now they're actually still running their best promotion ever. It is a limited time. It's $80 off of your first 4 boxes. The boxes do not have to be purchased in consecutive order, so you can skip a week or pause a week if you're going on vacation. There's 18 different meal options every week, and I just love the convenience of these, especially when I get home late and I don't want to think about anything, you know, putting anything together. Everything is done for me because all of the ingredients are on the back. So make sure you click my link down below in the comments and the description box to check it out. Let's go ahead and get started with this meal.
So this home chef dish was really easy to make. They all are. Another thing I wanted to note is don't be intimidated if you are just learning how to cook or want to learn how to cook better, because on their website you can pick from easy recipes, intermediate, advanced. They even now have the express meals, which are quicker and easier. And I believe now they also offer like a one pan assembly meal that you just put up everything together, throw it in the oven. So there's something for everybody. This dish came out really, really good. I have to say the little ciabatta bread was delicious as well. Make sure you guys take advantage of my offer right now, $20 off your first 4 boxes. And again, they do not have to be purchased in consecutive order. Just click my link in the description box down below and use code GradysMom80.
Hey guys, home from work, getting ready to start dinner. We are doing some mini sliders tonight. So I've got these Pepperidge Farm Sweet Hawaiian slider rolls. I've got my mini burgers here. Obviously, this is more than we're gonna eat tonight. So we plan to bring whatever's left to work tomorrow. And then I also made this cowboy caviar salad. Some people like this as a dip, which is fine, and I do sometimes, but I actually just like it as like a side dish, especially in the summer. It's really refreshing and very healthy. I really like it a lot. I'll leave a link down below to the recipe video for it that I did. We're also gonna have a few of these green giant broccoli and cheese tots. I really like these, so I'm gonna go ahead, get these in the oven, get these on the grill, and throw it all together.
Okay, so the sliders came out really good. They obviously shrink a lot when you grill them, but they were perfect on these little slider rolls, and I am just loving this cowboy caviar. It's definitely gonna become an obsession of mine this summer. I will leave a link to the video I did on it. It's really easy down below. So this night I had some sweet Italian sausage thawed out. I cut it up and put a little bit of EVOO in the bottom of a pot and sauteed it up. I used a little tiny store-bought sauce to make my homemade marinara sauce stretch a little bit further because I needed just a little bit more. I'll leave the link down below to my marinara sauce and let it simmer all together. I actually just scooped all the pasta into the plate, sort of assembly line, and then topped all of our plates with sauce and sausage. Grady's, it was in the little bowl. We topped it with Parmesan cheese, and we actually had a side salad, but I totally forgot to get the footage for that. And that was our dinner for tonight. So for dinner tonight, I had some garden green beans that my parents grew. So I just cut off the ends, threw them in some cold water, and I bring them to a boil for about 2 to 3 minutes. And then when they are done, I just drain them. I add a little bit of salt to the water, and they're good to go. We're going to do some spicy hot Italian sausage tonight, and I'm making a little side salad with cucumber, avocado, and tomatoes. I also ended up throwing in some radish with the Trader Joe's balsamic glaze. So after the green beans came to a boil, I put them back in the hot pot with some butter and some of the Trader Joe's onion salt and just kind of let them steam like that. And then, like I mentioned, I added radish and Kalamata olives to mine. Matt doesn't like Kalamata olives, and I topped it with Trader Joe's balsamic glaze, and it came out really good. Matt grilled up the sausage on the grill, and it was just an excellent dinner. So yeah, this is what we had tonight, and we'll see you guys tomorrow. So this night I made the Rana brand chicken mozzarella tortellini. I added some pesto sauce and parm cheese. I also made these side salads with a bunch of different veggies, and we had some Hidden Valley Ranch cheddar and bacon dressing, which was really good, and I love the Rana brand pasta. They make really good products.
All right, so I am getting ready to throw my dinner in the crock pot. I just stopped home really quick from work on lunch break. I've got my crock pot ready. I already had all my canned stuff out. I just opened up a can of diced tomatoes, a can of tomato sauce, a can of red beans, some chili mix, and then I had my ground beef thawed out, my onion chopped up. I literally just put it right in the frying pan so it was ready to go. So I drained all the fat out of this. I'm gonna put this in the crock pot first. And then I'm gonna get my diced tomatoes in, my beans in, my tomato sauce in. I'm gonna add my chili seasoning mix and put it all together. All right, I've got it stirred up. I love making this recipe because it's literally 5 ingredients, and I'm just gonna set it on low, and when I get home from work, all I will have to do is make the cornbread and boil the pasta because we eat our chili on like a bed of pasta. So I'll show you guys that later when I get home from work. All right guys, it's about 6 o'clock and I just got home and changed into comfy clothes, and I've got this Jiffy corn muffin mix ready to go in a little round baking dish. This is my favorite mix. It's like 50 cents, and I think it, just a preference, I think it tastes pretty good. I think it tastes better than, or just as good as like a mix that's way more expensive. So I'm gonna go ahead and get it in and get it in the oven. The chili is done, and I'm gonna get some pasta going, and we're gonna bring this together.
So this meal came out fantastic as always. It's just such an easy one, and I love making it year round. I'll leave the video down below for this chili. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing what we had for dinner this week. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.